Hi, I'm Tanner Faust, driver of the Rockstar Energy Global Rallycross Beetle, and you're watching ARS-TV.
This is Joseph Mills with Autobeta Products, and you're watching ARS-TV.
Shout out to ARS-TV in the building, Houston.
On today's show, we're celebrating our 100th episode. So buckle up, it's gonna be a fast ride.
Back then it was a Seagas 51 Chevy. It had a 270 vet in it, and it had a 37 LaSalle Cadillac gearbox and a floor shift. You could go through an intersection, shift all three gears before you even got to the other end.
Hi, Brent Jarvis here from Performance Restorations. We're with the SVRA today, Vintage Road Racing.
I'm Bob Orsolini. I'm with Orsolini Brothers Racing. We're here with the Chicago Wise Guys today, July 10th, Nitro Street Car Brawl. Later on, about 4 o'clock, the action will start. We're going to talk a little bit more about the current engine combination we're running. Again, this is a 526 cubic inch Allen Johnson Hemi. All billet, all aluminum, and specifically made for racing. This combination currently runs with a 1471 high helix blower, and they currently runs on alcohol.
We're here with Arnie, the farmer at Beswick. Arnie, you're going to make some passes tonight in this old beast. What are you expecting out of it?
Well, the car normally runs in the low sevens at 190-some mile an hour. You know, it's been as fast as 98, 99, a couple of times 100, 200, that is. So, depends on air and track conditions.
One of the senior racers has been coming out here for over 50 years, Arnie Beswick. We're glad you're here at the Time Machine Nationals, and we'll see you out there on the track.
You sure will. Thank you for the interview.
We've got the first annual Tennessee Rumble here at Cherry Bomb today, so we're going to get started on a plant tour and show everybody how it works here and how we make Cherry Bomb products.
This week we're here in the ARS garage. I've got Drew Diesner here with me.
Today we're in the ARS-TV garage with Tom Ruminski of the Crate Engine Depot.
So today I'm here with Mitch Micah, winner of the July Nitro Streetcar Brawl Modified Superstock Race.
Tonight we're with Pete and Tony Christie, organizers of Park on Park Car Show in Mundelein, Illinois.
Today in the garage we have Roger and Dan, veteran long haulers of the Hot Rod Power Tours. Welcome to the show, guys.
Hey, thanks for letting us be here.
Thanks.
All right.
Hey, we're here in the ARS-TV garage with Ryan Steffen of Freestyle Supermoto, and he has brought a couple of his bikes in today.
Tonight I'm here with Sean Baker, last Saturday night's winner of the Modified Superstock Race at Great Lakes Dragway.
Randy Henning from Great Lakes Dragway. Hello and how you doing? Have you noticed the snow's melting? We're going to be running at the racetrack in 6 weeks or less.
TJ Zizzo, driver of the Peak Motor Oil Top Fuel Dragster, and you are watching ARS-TV.
okay. That explosion was direct center interior of that Mercury safe. We don't know where he is. Is he out?
Destroyed in a matter of less than a second. Big round of applause. Let's make some noise. It's Benny, the one and only Benny the Bomb.
You ready? All right, I'm here with Bill Grumpy Jenkins here at the Muscle Car and Corvette Nationals 2011. And Bill's here standing next to two tribute cars that are owned by Mark Pappas. What do you feel? How do you feel about him carrying the legend of these tribute cars with your name on them?
Well, it's nice that he's not unique in this respect, but there's probably a half a dozen of them in the country of one kind or another over the years, and these seem to be done fairly well.
Great. What do you feel about them running the times that they ran back in the day? Is that kind of the standard for these tribute cars to run the times that they ran during pro stock days back in the 70s and 60s?
Well, I haven't even given that much thought, to tell you the truth. So I would say probably not. They ought to be better.
Oh, okay. What was one of your favorite cars that you actually raced and owned over the years?
Well, the car this was copied from was a 68 Camaro, and it was the most profitable car I ever had. And I started out with a car the first time it left the shop and went to a racetrack. It had about $8,000 tied up in it. And by the time I got done using it, at the end of 72, probably, it wasn't that late. But it made me at least $250,000.
Well, you don't hear that every day. Most of the time, people spend money and don't make any money at the track. So
that's not the idea.
Right, right. So, all right. Well, hey, thank you very much for the interview. We appreciate you being here and enjoy today.
All right, thank you.
All right, thanks, Paul. Appreciate it.
Nitrous-assisted cars, we got supercharged cars, we got turbo cars, and we got a couple cars that just run naturally aspirated.
How was competition out there?
Tough.
Tough interview here.
Yeah. The greatest guys in the world. We have fun. Win, lose, or draw, everybody's a buddy.
Thank you.
you doing? I'm Mike Ardito from Tri-Power Automotive. This here is one of the real deal cars we get in here, Tri-Power 67 L88, that actually raced at Daytona, 24-hour Daytona race, 1970 it ran.
At the 2013 Race and Performance Expo, and I'm here with Christy Edelbrock. Christy, you've been come to every one of these, so this is the sixth annual. What keeps bringing you out to Chicago?
Oh, the lovely weather, of course.
Oh, you like the snow that we got the past couple of days, huh?
It's pretty. Yeah. It's the wonderful people here, you know? The Bingham family, the whole group, the whole Winter Circle group, the volunteers. Okay. And look at the kids sitting up there watching them checking armbands and everything. And the Hot Rodders of Tomorrow Engine Challenge, of course.
So the objective here is to hide all the wiring so we don't see any of that, or try not to. So all this is going to be formed sheet metal, inner fenders, firewall, flat firewall, nothing protruding through it. So we want to keep it as clean as possible.
I'm Jeff Schwartz from Schwartz Performance. Today we're introducing our new project. It's a 1971 Camaro. We're building this for Raybestos Brakes. This is the 2014 Raybestos Brakes giveaway car.
Hey, I got some great news. I'm going to have time this year to run some of the Great Lakes Dragway races with this car, my favorite car, this one here, the 41 Willys, and also my alcohol dragster. So that's the great news. Years ago, we decided to build a 41 Willys street car. Well, it ended up going from a street car to a really, really fast street car, and now it's pretty much ready to go to Union Grove, Wisconsin to beat it up.
We're back in the ARS-TV garage, and again, I've got our good friend Mike Ruth from Heights Automotive Group. Mike, welcome again, and we're glad to see you.
Always good to see you, Dave. It's always a pleasure to come down to your garage, see what you have going on.
Yeah.
What's new with you?
You know, we're busy at work. We seem to shoot video every day, and of course, you know, I'm out there. We're here in the ARS-TV garage, and I have a super special guest flown in all the way from Olympia, Washington, formerly of Seattle. Jay Rollins, the director, writer, and leading actor of Clutch. We are so pleased to have you here in the garage, and welcome.
Well, thank you very much. And all I got to say is I'm stoked to be here. I want to thank ARS and Heights for, you know, putting on such a great event. And like I said, I'm just stoked to be down here and be a part of it, man.
Yeah. Hey, it's Dave from ARS-TV, and today we've got a special guest. This is Tom Sarmento, and he's one of my local heroes just for the fact that he's had the privilege of being the head builder and lead mechanic on the Dukes of Hazzard show. Yeah. I'm excited about that. Welcome. Thanks
for
being here.
Good to have you.
ARS-TV, you guys are bad to the bone.
And you probably know me for Top Fuel Drag Racing. Yeah.
Yeah.
This is ARS-TV, number one for motorsports. So here we are in Norwalk, Ohio, the home of the racetrack. You know the deal. Everybody comes here either to race or to hang out or to barbecue. Today, it's just a huge event. So many people. The Hot Rod Power Tour 2014. I came to see this ride. Have you seen what's going on with this car? Check this out. Look, I mean, you really have to dig deep to find all the really cool things, but I would not want to be a person who gets next to this car on the track because it is not only cool looking, but it is as fast as it is cool looking.
Hi everyone, welcome to the 2014 Hot Rod Power Tour. We are here in beautiful Ohio. We're hoping for no rain, wishing there's no rain. Thanks for checking us out. And if you ever need any wiring, please come check us out at Painless Performance Wire. Thanks, bye-bye.
Wisconsin here this Memorial Weekend.
Welcome, ARS-TV listeners. This is Mike Gould, the Red Baron at Great Lakes Dragway, Union Grove, Wisconsin, where we're at the Memorial Day Classic with the one and only living legend, Big Daddy Don Garlitz.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Dave Despain. You're watching ARS-TV. Good for you.
Hey, welcome to the Hot Rod Power Tour. My name is Clarence Barnes, and this is ARS-TV.
I'm Joseph Mills with Autometer Products, and you're watching ARS-TV.
Sure to stop by our Facebook fan page to keep up with everything going on with ARS Promotions and ARS TV.